Hello and welcome, everyone.
Hello.
Good evening. Thank you for all coming tonight. This is going to be a wonderful evening featuring some great piano music by my good friend Jim Chappelle and myself. We're going to be playing some Christmas songs as well as some of our original music. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome Jim Chappelle.
Thank you for coming. I think we're going to have a nice time tonight. I know I am. Sun Sprinkles, that's on a new best of album I just released not too long ago, and it kind of reminds me of a Christmas song, even though it's written, I played it earlier this afternoon. It's written about sunlight on the water, the little dancing of the sprinkling. Anyway, this next This next song I'm going to do has a really cool connection to the area, and I've told this story all over the world actually, but it actually happened right here in Pacific Grove, which is pretty cool. Are you guys familiar with the Bookworks? Mm-hmm. Yeah, just down the street there. I used to live close to the Bookworks many years ago, and when my career was just starting, and I walked in there, and they had my music. It was actually on cassette, so I'm dating myself. That means I must be 39 by now. But anyway, I walked in there, my music's playing. I was like, oh, I was like, that's cool. And the girl behind the counter, she's like, hey, what do you think of this piano music? And I was like, I like it. She says, oh, I just love it. She goes, every time I work my shift, I always put this album on. And I was like, cool, that's great. You know, I was a little shy about it, so I just kind of went, well, like, you know, and walked away. And then, you know, she's bye when I leave. And then I came in like a week later. I walked in and she's like, hey, you're the guy that likes that piano music that I like. I said, that's me. And she goes, you know what? He's doing a concert here. Which is true. You know, like 3 weeks from then, I was doing a concert. And she goes, are you going? And I said, I'm pretty sure I am. And she goes, well, maybe I'll see you there. And I'm like, I'm pretty sure you will. So, long story short, and I still, you know, I was still like going, wow, how do I get out of this one now? So, you know, I played the concert, and afterwards, people, a lot of times you're signing CDs or cassettes and people want to say hi. There's a little dressing room, green room area, you know, and I'm kind of going, I wonder if that girl came, but, you know, and then I look out front, you know, she's standing in the corner with her arms folded. I got this really bad look on her face. I look at her and she goes, that wasn't funny. So, anyway, the story's dragging here a little bit, but what happened was I felt kind of crummy. I said, well, can I take you out for coffee or something? I said, I apologize. I didn't know. Okay, you know. We started dating eventually. And about a month or two after that, a couple months after that, I think it was, she said, you know what? I'm kind of getting freaked out because this is going a little too fast. I guess we were pretty romantically involved, apparently. And so she goes, I think we should take a break. And I'm like, oh, okay. Really? And she's like, yeah. So anyway, longer story short, I said, okay. And I lasted about 2 weeks or so. And then I went, this is horrible. I said, I'm going to write a song for her. And I'm going to put it on a cassette tape. Did I say that word again? Put it on a cassette tape. And then I'm going to take it secretly to her door and say, please take me back. You know, so this was my love song to her in the attempts for her to say, geez, why would I ever leave you, you know, or something like that. But this is called Heart Song. Thank you. So the good news is the dating kept going. Lucky for me. This is a piece, this is one of my favorite pieces. I first remember hearing as a very young child, and I started playing, I think it was first grade or so, and it was one of the Easy Learn books, and just a week or so ago, I thought this would be fun to put a version of this together for this, and so we'll see how this goes. This is called O Holy Night, and I'm sure you've heard it before. Thank you. Thank you, and now we have a wonderful pianist composer coming up. This guy, thank you, Michael, for bringing me here too. This is really cool. Here he comes.
I got so much technology in this room, it's crazy.
So I'm having to transition from a four camera angle guy to a piano guy, so. But once again, it's so great to see all of you here supporting live music, especially solo piano music. I've kind of been getting this idea to just really make solo piano music popular and just really push it out as much as I can. And, you know, hearing Jim for the first time, I actually found his music on YouTube. It was just that one song entitled Gone, which struck me in the heart. It was so beautiful, and I was like, who is Jim Chappell? And for the next couple years, I wanted to have him come here. And so here he is playing wonderful music, and it's just these moments that are so precious to me. So thank you all for coming and enjoying. So,
thank you.
Thank you. So I'd like to. I'm sure you've heard me play this song in service in Sunday morning before, but I'd like to play it again. This is my mentor's piece entitled Carmel Christmas, and my mentor was Jonathan Lee. He was a local pianist and composer in the area, and I only got to know him for about a year and a half until he passed away. But the effect that he brought on me and my music was profound. He wasn't a very complicated player, but the notes he did play, they were so well timed and so well thought out. It became ingrained in me after a while, and it's just something that I've never let go. And you know, when he passed away, I wanted to inherit that, and somehow it just became a part of me. So let me bring out Jonathan Lee for you. His song, Carmel Christmas.
Thank you.
Thank you. So next I'd like to play Carol of the Bells in the style of George Winston, Jonathan Lee, and myself. So I just mashed it all together, and it's kind of cool that way. So here it is. Jim, back up to the stage here.
This is a lot less dangerous than big time wrestling. You know, the tag team where you go in. I love the way Michael plays. I'd like to thank the center here. This is a really cool environment. I've had a chance to get to know more about what you're doing here, and it's really a great service to the community, and I just think it's a great organization. There's so much going on in the world today, and you know, everything that you guys are doing is just a great way to assimilate it and work work with yourself. It's an awesome organization, so hats off to all of you. This is a piece. I have this pretty cool history growing up in Michigan. I grew up in Michigan as a child, and it was kind of like a sort of a fairyland existence because I lived near lakes and streams and woods, and when I was younger, I didn't get cold outside. And one day in particular, we had just a really fun thing. My father took the family out to the countryside, and it was a surprise for us, and we loaded up on a horse-drawn sleigh with some horses and little bells on them, and they drove us around for like 45 minutes up through the countryside, and it was really cool. I was probably 4 years old or something, but I put it on my first album, this song that I recreated that in my mind and wrote music to it, and the title of this piece, it's kind of like my only Christmas song. I think it would probably work as a Christmas song, actually, but it's called Magic Sleigh Ride. Since I was probably 15 years old, and I was always really excited when I would put a new song together that I thought came together well, and I would be like, wow, this is such a great feeling, you know, composing music and creating something that hopefully will be around, you know, if I'm lucky after I'm gone, someone will still be listening to something somewhere, and I thought, this is the best. there's nothing better than this. I have this feeling, you know. And then I turned into a father. And I thought, oh my God, you know, I saw my daughter for the first time, and I remember just going, what was I thinking with the music? This is and the only thing that came to me is like, this is the true miracle here. This is a miracle, seeing this new soul come in, and she's done nothing but light up my life ever since then, and I just feel super blessed, and I wrote a piece for her on one of my albums that I'm really proud of the way it turned out. This is called Miracle.
Thank you.
That was beautiful, Jim. It's kind of inspired me to play a piece that I wrote. It's called Divine Heart. And very mysterious how I started composing it. I was just improvising one day on the piano, and the melody came out of nowhere. And I took it and I made it into a song. And, you know, just later on, just composing the piece, there's some moments that you feel inside are so amazing and beautiful. Music is a way to capture that and just keep it still in time and space. And it's such a beautiful thing to revisit that every time you play. And that's the beautiful thing about music. So here's my song entitled Divine Heart.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next, I'd like to play another heart-related song. This is called The Heart's Desire. And it's just so filled with joy, and most oftentimes what I feel when I come to the center every Sunday. So it brings back good memories. So this is my song entitled The Heart's Desire. Bring Jim back up on stage here. Oh, I got it. There it is.
I'll explain it, people.
I'm still like a child that needs a booster chair. Otherwise, I just feel like I'm playing like this. But there's a song that came to me at one point in my life where I just realized that I was trying to process, I was thinking of all the things I had lost since I was a child, and it was like, I was going back and I was like, well, my first pet dog got hit by a car, and then another dog got hit by a car, and then, you know, then I was a teen and I fell in love with the girl that dumped me, and then I was like, oh, and then I lost that. And I was thinking about all these different things in my life, and I just sat down one day and wrote this piece of music that tried to capture the fact that even though I'd lost, oh, best friends and both of my parents and everything, there's this thing, this powerful spiritual thing that set in to my heart after these losses that opened my heart more to love and to divine spirit. And it was like, I realized that, you know, all of us are going to leave at some point, and I just got in touch with the fact that the present moment is really kind of all we have, and this song tries to capture that feeling of letting go of someone you love very deeply, or something that was taken from you, and being able to move into a place of you know, like a new state of consciousness because of it, and actually more light and more love coming in. So anyway, this is a piece called Gone. Thank you. So what was happening, I'd be playing different concerts, and I've been lucky enough to play outside the country and a lot of different other areas outside the United States. And what would happen was people would come, they would be interested in you know, oh, I would really like a certain song, and they're like, what album is that on? And it was getting kind of confusing, you know, because it's like, well, I think it's on, because I have 20 albums now. So what I did was I took the most popular pieces of solo music that I've written, and I put them all on one best of album. So, and I play a lot of those when I perform live by myself. I play a lot of those songs, so it's pretty cool because almost everything that I play is on one album, so people they can find it. It's like, what song is that? And the, you know, the person selling CDs, they just go like that, it's right there. This is the first piece I ever recorded. I really love the feeling I get when I play this, because it just, it's it reminds me of what a happy child I was as a kid. Or I probably couldn't have created something like this, but this is one of my favorite pieces from, it's sort of painful to say this, but 1985 is when I wrote it. And pretty soon I'll be like 107 or something. Yeah.
1985.
Anyway, this is called Blue Racer. Thank you.
Oh, that was great, Jim. I feel like racing around. I'd like to play, this is my last round here at the piano. So I'd like to play We Three Kings. And for those of you who were at my 2 p.m. concert, you probably heard it already. But here it is again.
Thank you.
We're going to have Jim finish it off for us.
So, I've done this maybe a handful of times when I perform, but it's sometimes it seems really fun to do. So, what I'm going to try to do is sort of get the vibe of the room and just improvise a last piece for you guys and see how that goes. And it's luckily for me, I'm going to try to do this. I worked for a number of years with a lot of different dance departments in colleges where I was sort of forced to, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, play, you know. You know, and the dance teacher would carve out a movement for the dancers, and I had to just start playing. It was like, when I first started, it was like, what do I play? That's up to you, sir. It's like, okay. Do you want me to read music? No, sir. You just make it up. And it was like, wow, okay. So at first I was like freaking out for a while. But anyway, I'm just going to pretend you're dancers, even though you're sitting here, and see what happens here. But thank you so much for coming out tonight. Thank you, Michael, for inviting me. I really appreciate it.